Okay, cool.
Alright, so,
Alright, we're in Flame 2019.2.1.
Okay, first issue is...
I mean, we're only going to describe one issue here.
Yes,
then we'll do the next
Very good, very good. Alright, so the issue that I have here is I have a timeline, and in this layer, on this timeline, as you can see as I spread this out, I have zero handle. I've condensed all these to zero handle. So all these clips, and this is just a layer of clips, and which all originally had handles, but now I've eliminated.
Can you explain what you did to?
Yes, I've gone into here and I've highlighted all my segments, and I have selected the track, and I've hard committed. I'll do it again. Boom. So it keeps all my cuts, but it eliminates all of the handle. So now I have zero handle on everything. So every single one of these clips, zero handle.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go back to the beginning. Now what I want to do is change the time code, both record and source, and in sequence. So I'm going to highlight this whole layer, and I'm going to hit match.
And you're using Smoke Hotkeys?
Yes.
Smoke Classic?
Yes.
Okay.
So I'm hitting match. I'm going to match all these out. As you can see here, I'm going to take this match and put it up into just a reel here. In just a moment, the reel will populate. And you can see now I have in sequence all of the clips from the first one to the last one. And what I want to do is highlight all those clips. And I want to change the time code, source and record, to start at a specific time code.
Now, is this a bug or a feature request?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
Well, I think it's a bug.
Okay.
Or I'm not doing something wrong. I'm doing something wrong.
Okay.
So if I go to reformat here, again, all these should have zero handles on them. I want to change the time code. I want to do a source record time code change, sequential, so the first will start. The time code at 59, first frame, first clip will start at 59:52, and then each one will follow in time code. So I've got source record, got sequential on, a new start and rate. And I'm starting it at, right here at 59:52. I hit reformat. And now I want to pick this up, and I want to put this back in my timeline, all those clips, and then as you can see, I'm going on top here. Now watch when I stretch this out.
Whoa, that's crazy.
All my handles come back.
Right. Okay, so that's a bug.
So that's a bug.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure why that is.
Okay.
And now my time code does not work. So it's because it has all this handle in it. So I'm going to do this again. So now here's what I have to do. I'm going to throw away what I had in that folder over there. I'm going to take this one that I just tried to change the time code on, and I'm going to do this again. I'm going to hard commit again these segments. I select current track. I'm going to hit hard commit. Now everything's back to zero again. As you can see, this layer is back to zero. All the handles are at zero again. Now if I do it again, it'll work. So I'm going to highlight this. I'm going to match out, hit match. Go back to this folder up here. I'm going to repeat what I just did. First frame up here. And I'm going to go to reformat. And have the same parameters. Time code change, sequential time code, source and record, new start and rate at 59:52. I'm going to hit reformat. Now I'm going to go down here and just create another layer in this timeline. I'm going to take what I just did again here, and I'll bring it down here. And now you'll see, now it needs to be where it needs to be. And all the time codes, you can see, source and record match all the way down the line. From the first clip, which starts at the time code that I put in, to 59:52 even, to the last clip, and everything matches. Source and record match. So I got to do that twice. Got to put it in a folder, reformat it, put it in the timeline, pull it out of the timeline again, reformat exactly the same, and put it in. Then it works. I'm not sure why I have to do that twice. It should just work once.
Yep. Okay.
That's it.
All right. Thanks.